I'm going to put a little bend in my knees. Just keep my hands on my hips for now. And I'm going to start to hinge from the waist with a long spine. All right, so as I'm hinging from my waist, I'm not rounding. All right, if anything, there's maybe a little bit of arch, but the belly should be lifted. And again, I'm hinging from my waist so my spine continues to stay long. All right, notice my legs are not locked. If you lock your legs here, you're going to put a lot more pressure on your lower back. So it's good to keep a little bend in your knees. And if you're really tight, you can even keep more of a bend in your knees. Right, you want to feel the mobility from a long spine standing up, hinging from your waist. And then notice when you get tight here, it might be halfway, it might be a little bit more than halfway. That's pretty much your edge. All right. And you want to try to keep a long spine until that very last moment, which is your edge. And then when you're done there, that's when you just can kind of round a little bit into it. All right. Same thing goes for standing up. So as I glance forward, I'm going to create some of that length again. Belly draws in. The spine elongates forward. Might fold forward one more time to feel the stretch of my hamstrings. Notice I'm never locking my legs out. There's always at least a little bend in my knees. Okay, and then as I come up, and I'm going to do this one with my hands on my waist again. A little bend in my knees, my hands are at my waist. I want to lengthen my spine as I rise up. Right? I'm not rounding up. The belly is lifted to support it, and I'm lengthening and reaching through the crown of my head. So this really energetic movement through the torso. All right, now I'm going to add the arms.